New York Giants, and I gotta get my ICTV.
Good morning, Gal Nation.
Is your mic on?
Is your mic on?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah.
We're hot messes in the morning. Welcome back to two guys and Uno Gale. Actually, three guys in the Gale, actually.
Yep.
A third
we have a
today.
Very special guest on before we graduate. I really can't hear myself right now. Oh, whoa,
go.
whoa. Coffee is not seeping through the veins yet. Mr. Matt Ricker asked me yesterday, he's like, before you graduate, I definitely want to do a show with you. And I said, what better show to be on than two guys in the Gale?
Yeah,
thanks for having me, guys.
No problem.
Of course.
Our pleasure. He's like the politics king. He's gonna give a very fun and interesting twist on that. And he made me realize that next week is our last week on the air. A week from today is our last two guys in the Gale.
Wow.
I don't know. It won't be the same without you guys.
It was such a long year, but it was so much fun, though.
Because we were honestly just talking about it.
Yeah.
We've had hundreds and thousands of views on YouTube. We're just our show alone.
Sounds like we got hundreds of thousands of views.
We're not joking.
Yeah, like 100.
You're a little ahead of yourself.
Like thousands. Easily 2,000 views. Besides 12,000.
One measly thousand.
No, we broke 1,000. Had to.
You think?
Yeah,
because the 800 views on the JoJo one.
All right.
That really did have a lot of views. You probably got like 1,200.
Yeah.
One.
Yeah, I that sounds reasonable. And before we get into reality news, okay, you know how I interviewed Joe Santagato earlier in the semester?
Yeah.
So last night, I loved his YouTube videos, especially the Mad Lib videos.
I was watching that last night, yo.
So
funny.
Last night, I was Snapchatting my RA and WICR host, Steve Pierce, and his girlfriend Nora, like laughing at one of the videos, and I decided to tweet it at Joe Santagato. He retweeted it and said, this is one of the greatest things ever. It got about 500 favorites and 38 retweets, and I got about 12 different followers for no reason. Let's see, it's 504 favorites and 38 retweets.
What did you say in the tweet?
I literally said, watching Keith Santagato and Joe Santagato mad libs and stumbling upon the boogie like. I can't make this up.
Wow, Joe Santagato and Chelsea Taylor Harris are best friends all of a sudden.
No, we're not.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
No, we're not.
You're best friends with everyone, aren't you? Like, didn't you meet Donald Trump when you were younger?
I didn't. My mom met him, and it's my mom's birthday next. It's almost been 2 years. It's 2 years my mom's birthday.
You see this? You're famous. So
no,
jealous.
We should, for senior week, though, we should try to get Joe Santagato back on. Is that an idea?
I'd be down.
Sure.
What are we doing during senior week?
We'll talk about it all.
And then, like, a few other people are coming on. Okay. Entertainment news. Sorry, Ricker. We just went on a very... That's how we go.
I'm not enjoying being here.
We're very real. We're very all over the place. That's me, though.
As always.
I'm the train wreck, according to Mario. Okay. Entertainment news. So, lots of ish happening with Kesha, because I was losing my mind when I saw this on Instagram yesterday, because I'm losing my mind a lot, because 1 week left. Zedd dropped an Instagram that said, I quote, if the internet online pops up, it said, the photo said, Zedd and Kesha, True Colors, officially out, 429. Music can be freedom, Zedd shared on social media. Just to clarify, we didn't use any loopholes. Kemo Sabe / RCA gave us permission to release the song. And Dr. Luke responded, thanks for the clarification, at Zedd.
Wow.
What do y'all think about this? Cause,
so they're dropping a song tomorrow. Is that what it's
called?
Yep. 429. It was called True Colors.
True Colors. And they just... Kesha came on Zedd's side of Coachella.
I don't know. I feel like just the title of the song is going to be very powerful. I feel. I don't know. True Colors. What do you think?
Isn't that the song that they performed at Coachella?
Yes. And that was on his last album as well. Which is the remake.
Is Zedd signed to Kesha's label, whatever, the same label? Do you know?
I didn't investigate that.
No
but
idea.
All I know is that I love him and I've seen him in concert once and I was losing my mind.
I mean, I still think it's great, whatever. She needs to release a song. She's clearly processing whatever emotion it is that she's going through with this late, with this, you know, this whole situation. So Shout out to Kesha. Shout out to Zedd for accepting her and, you know, and helping her go through it, you know?
Definitely.
What about you, Matt Rucker? What do you think about this?
Well, when I heard about this, I thought, you know, I'm glad to see that Kesha is coming back. You know, I haven't listened to her in, you know, maybe a few years now, yeah. 2 or 3 years. Mm-hmm. You know, that's, she hasn't released anything new in a while. So yep. I'm glad to see her coming back. You know, it'll be interesting to see, you know, how popular it gets. And I'm sure it will, it, like any artist, it will become very popular.
Absolutely. Definitely. Go Kesha. Go Kesha. Instead, it happens to be one of my favorite artists alive. So, if he has a song called Alive, Zedd fans.
Zedd. What a guy.
He is what a guy. I love him.
What
he looks
a
like
guy. A,
he looks like a little alien. Who doesn't like aliens?
Like an alien?
Like a cute wow. alien.
Wow.
I love him, though. I think he's adorable.
And okay. on that note.
More EDM, technically EDM news. Okay. So, Coachella happened the past 2 weekends, and last week, Calvin, the one and only Calvin Harris, brought out a very special guest on the set. Do you know who that is?
Who was that special guest, Chelsea?
You tell me.
We spoke about it. It was Riri.
Okay, so this...
Riri.
Work. So, isn't this convenient now? This is getting dropped too? Okay, the music producer took to Twitter to reveal that he's got an upcoming track with Rihanna saying, this is what you came for. Taylor Swift's boyfriend teased fans. This is all from E! News, by the way, because E! News is popping this morning. On social media, tweeting that he was going to be sharing details about his new music towards the end of the day. To show her support, Taylor Swift, posted on Instagram that the same cover art Calvin shared, writing, oh my god. This track is currently slated for April 29th as well, which is mañana, just days after Drake is expected to release his highly anticipated album, Views from the Six.
That's all I care about. I don't care that Zedd is dropping. I really don't care that who's this? Calvin Harris is dropping his song. All I care about is that Views is coming out tomorrow.
Views from the Six.
Everyone's dropping new music lately. What the hell?
And Meek Mill will be dropping his mixtape tomorrow and on the same day. So
is he really? Meek Mill gets no views.
No, he actually he will. Surprisingly, he will. That is some drama there.
It'd be funny.
I just got that.
did you just get that tied together?
I got the Meek Mill drink thing, Nicki Minaj.
Chelsea, what'd you do before the show?
I did a reality show segment. Quick little segment. Coffee. I did get my coffee and I had my eggs. Are we? Is this we have not been talking for 10 minutes, but what's lemonade's coming out? True Colors coming out.
Lemonade came out.
And we got hate on it for it. We got hate on it from YouTube, by the way.
Oh, did we really?
And people were texting me. Funny. The normal iTunes release date is normally on a Tuesday. What Friday?
Can we actually talk about your hate for Lemonade? Because I heard about it.
From Spring?
Of course I did. You know I did.
I have to.
It's so funny.
Spring texted me too.
Yeah.
I have to watch the video. I have to watch the visual.
Watch that.
Did you listen to the entire album?
I listened because I'm broke AF right now, so I couldn't get the title. I listened to the previews. There's one song that I love on there, and I can't wait for money to be restored.
So you judge the album based on listening to the little 30 second preview.
A minute and a half, actually. No, thank you so much.
Chelsea, you are a troublemaker. That's what you are. You know, you need to watch the visual album, okay? Watch it. Because it was released as a visual album, so it's meant to be watched. So I think, you know, do your research, okay? Watch
do
it.
Do my research.
Do your research.
I sat down and listened to it, and I let the hop sauce in my bag swag, and I just got that pun.
You heard a minute and a half of it.
I like the song Sorry, though. Sorry's popping. Sorry's very much popping. I also like songs that are named Sorry because it just. What do you think about all these music release dates, Matt Ricker?
You know, to tell you the truth, I have not been up on, you know, the latest music. If you look at my playlists on iTunes, you'll be like, why are you listening to all this played out music?
Like the Verge's style.
But no, I really don't have the time to keep up with the music. I'm just like, I like the old music, so why not keep the old music?
Fair enough. At least you're honest.
And by old music, I mean music that has come out in the past 2 or 3 years, which is extremely old. And
okay, so what would you listen to?
Yeah, what would you
song?
Listen to?
Yeah.
It's Throwback Thursday. Let's embrace it.
Good question. That's a good question. I like all types of genres, really. Country, rock, pop. Pop is really a good one.
So more
I'd
of the
story. I'd say Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift.
Oh. We're going to talk about that after this commercial break.
Taylor Swift and Philip Phillips.
Phillips, that's a good one. But Taylor Swift, we're not even going to get into that. We're not going to get into that because y'all know my hate for Taylor Swift.
You don't like a lot of people in music.
I like most, but Taylor Swift is a little ho-ho-ho. She's a ho-ho-ho. On that note, we're going to Santa Claus on out until our next segment. We'll be right back.